Welcome back to Fendt Farm. As you can see, we have a bit of a problem. Our feed ratio is off. So, as it stands, we are not making power food. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually unload here. Just a little bit. And hopefully, we can fix our issue this way. Although I've got a feeling we're actually dumping out the wrong thing here. Let's see what happens if I add in extra silage. It's kind of helped, but still hasn't really helped, if that makes sense. Let's try it a little bit more. I'm going to drop the rest of that on the ground if I'm not careful. Need to raise the claw. There we go. So spit out a bit more. Okay, oh, for a second then we actually had the right ratio. Just for a second, we actually had the right ratio, so we're not far off now. But if we're going to have to do this on a consistent basis, it's going to be a real pain. So, going forward, I think what I'm going to do is just try adding in some more of this. See if that will bring us balance back. Again, see, we haven't got that balance right with our ratio. That's weird. Now it's telling me the ratio does look right when I start mixing it. I'm not entirely sure what is going on here. That's auto gates on this map, isn't it? I keep forgetting. Well, let's try unloading and see what happens. Because this is definitely an issue. I'm also curious, actually, this is the first time we've actually dropped any food in here, so I'm going to try and position the camera a bit better. There we go. They see that's just dropping out the straw. Now it's dropping out the silage. No, not the hay. Sorry, hay first. Now the silage. And it won't accept the straw. Okay. So I think what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to build a small pile of straw and manually shovel the straw in separately to make sure that we get the mix right. I was going to say, why won't that unload? I think it's because the pile is too big next to the. There we go. Let's get the rest of that straw out a bit. That should be enough, actually. That's a little over half a bale. So this is not the way I really wanted to kind of do this, unfortunately, but needs must, as it were. Let's shovel up a load more of this. This is probably going to be too much hay, but we might be able to get away with it. Let's put a bale in. I need to move that tractor out of the way because it's now in the way. So yeah, this has been, a little bit of a cluster. Trying to get this mix working. Yeah, going forward, what we might have to do is just drop in a bale of hay a couple of shovels of silage, and then scoop up the rest in straw loose. Okay, so now yeah, if we top the rest of this up with silage. This has not been the smoothest of operations, I will admit to that. Unfortunately, I was a little worried, but someone told me in the comments that it would be fine with this particular mixer, you know, not having any issues with the mix ratio, and it turns out, you know, I was right to be worried. You know, there are definitely, you can't do just one of each, it just will not work, which is what I suspected. You know, I was pretty sure that you couldn't do the 33% ratio anymore. And it turns out that has been proved to be correct. Alright, so now we actually have power food. Let's add a little bit more silage just to top that up a bit more. I think actually we're at maximum feed capacity in our troughs as well, which means I can't actually add power food. But yeah, this has turned out to be a little bit, yeah, as I say, a bit messy. I was hoping we could really go straight to a 100% productivity on our cows, and given that we haven't been able to give them power food, it looks as though that is not going to be the case. Alright, so that's now full. Check the ratio is okay. Yeah, the ratio is fine there, look. So, yeah, definitely going forward, we're going to have to just scoop in loose straw. So what I may do is, going forward, we'll sell the rest of this silage, and then we'll make some silage bales, and we'll stack those next to the hay bales. And then we'll drop in some loose straw. I don't know. Apparently you can actually drop in TMR on this map at the silo. So we may just make a huge batch of TMR, and that way we can just transport it down to the farm when we need it. But I want to see if I can actually deposit this food first of all. Going in the wrong way, really. Yeah, we're full. We can't unload any more food. So let's have a look. You can see they've got straw, they've got silage and hay, but no power food. It says we're at maximum on the food trough, but I don't know, maybe I've got to turn this thing around and actually have it closer to the tip point. Maybe that's why it wasn't unloading. It just seems, yeah, if we've got 100% food, that would actually be a full bar. So let's try unloading now. There we go. Oh, now it's unloading. So, yeah, you can see, look, the ratios are going up. So we're going to have too much hay and silage. And then we're going to have some power food. And the two of those combined together will equal, you know, by the look of it, a full food trough. We still need to get some grass for these guys as well. Alright, so we go two scoops of silage, one bale of hay, and then the rest as a bale of, as you know, loose straw. That will be how we have to feed them. It's a little clunky, but it is what it is. like a larger capacity bucket here as well. So we may look at investing in a larger bucket of some kind, be it just a different attachment or a different piece of equipment. So that's the first of our scoops of silage. Let's get another one in there. There we go. So that's the second scoop. Oops. I do love that mixing design in on the interior. That mechanism is so much nicer than to look at than the what is basically a giant blender that we have at the moment on everything else, with the silo king equipment and even the big modded 64,000 litre capacity one. Essentially it's just like that, those giant rotary blades at the bottom. It's nice to actually have a different mechanism. So apart from the fact that this mixing capacity is not quite as high as I would like, it'd be nicer if it could go to 16. If it was 16, it would make mixing using this a joy, because it'd be a nice simple ratio of one bale of one type, one bale of another type, and then two bales of the third type. Really straightforward and easy. As it is, with the 12,000, we can't go one of each because you end up with too much straw. So you end up having to do manual scooping. Just slows the process down a little bit. I mean, it doesn't make it game breaking by any means, or stretching the imagination, but it does mean that there is a little bit more work involved. And while we only have a few cows, that's not going to be a problem, but when we start getting more cows and we have to put in more food, those delays are going to start to become a bit of an issue. So we may have to look at as I say, batch mixing, dumping at the silos, or even just creating a storage point down here somewhere and just storing it in there. Trying not to kill the cows. There we go. So a little funny moment today. I was doing my shopping. You've played too much Farming Simulator. When you go do your shopping at the supermarket, and as you're walking past an end display and you see these green and yellow cans and you just glimpse the word John at the corner of your eye, your first thought isn't, oh, that's John West Tuna. It's, oh, that's John Deere Tuna. You know that your sense of reality has started to become a little bit warped. When you start thinking that a tractor company is responsible for making tuna. So had to stop and take a little pic. I may even add it into the video. Just so you can see what it looks like. But yeah, I'm going to do that. I'm going to add that photo into the just so you can see what I'm talking about. I'll add the photo into the video. So we'll do a little crossfade into the photo and then back again. So there you go. Yeah, that is the that is the mighty can of John Deere tuna. It's just when your brain's on autopilot and you've been gaming a lot, and sometimes you just don't think things through. And the stupid stuff happens. That's what happened there. But it made me chuckle, so I thought I'd take that picture. I do love the way the food is being piled up here at the gates, as it is on a more traditional farm. I think that's awesome. I really love this. Such a nice visual, just to have the food piled up like that. It's a little, you know, looks a little hokey if you view it from the wrong angle. But yeah, really, really nice little touch. That really, a lot more authentic, I think. So we haven't quite filled up the power food, but we're out of loose straw, and we could. Yeah, let's shred another bale, or another two bales, and tip it out. We'll have to tip the straw over here somewhere. Oops. Come on. Learn to reverse. There we go. That's what we want. So let's get two bales of straw. We'll shred those. And then we can mix one more batch of power food, and that should be enough then to fill up the power food bar. I remember on 15, it used to be that your food trough had a maximum capacity. And you know, you could feed them with hay, and you could feed them with silage as individual food types. And then you could feed them with total mixed ration. So there were three potential food sources for your cows. We didn't have a separate grass trough on 15. I can't remember if we had to give them... I'm pretty sure we had to give them water as well. I honestly can't remember. But in terms of the food trough... no, I don't think we had to. We don't think we had to give them water either. I think it was literally we just had to give them, you know, something to eat. So we gave them. You could give them just hay, just silage, or total mixed ration. And if you gave them hay and silage as food types, they would start to use up some of that total capacity of your food trough. And then once you reached kind of maximum capacity for those, once you put a load of those in, then you decided you want to fill them up with some TMR to fill up the rest of the 6 day allowance, then you would reach your final sort of maximum allowance of food for 6 days. But it wasn't a total like on this. It seems to be a total that is set purely for each section. On 15, I'm probably not explaining myself very clearly on this one, but on 15, say you had a total storage of 10,000 litres. I know it's a very small amount, but go with me on this. Let's say 10,000 litres. So let's say that you put in 2,000 litres of straw, no, sorry, of hay, and then you put in 2,000 litres of silage. You've got 4,000 litres worth of food in your trough, and you've got space for another 6. Now, if you put in 6,000 litres of total mixed ration, that's your total there. That's it. That's your total capacity gone. It wasn't 10,000 litres capacity for hay, a separate 10,000 litre capacity for straw, for silage, and then a separate 10,000 litre capacity for silage. For TMR, it was just a overall capacity, and then whatever you put in started to eat into that allowance. Not necessarily a problem, but to get your cows to 100% productivity, you needed to feed them TMR. Again, you've kind of done that. That's not a problem. But here's the other thing. The cows would only eat one food type at a time. So if you had hay there and just hay, then they would eat the hay and you would get a productivity of, say, I think it was 60-70%, something like that. If you gave them silage, then the productivity went up to, I think, 80%. If you gave them TMR, that was what would boost them all the way up to 100. But they would always eat the best food source available and just that food source until it was gone. And then they would go to the next best food source. So if you had a trough with TMR, separate silage, and separate hay, they would eat all the TMR first. And then they would eat the silage. And then they would eat the hay. And their productivity would drop as they moved through the different food types until they got to the worst one. And there's not necessarily a major problem, but seeing as that to get them at 100%, you wanted to give them TMR. You basically had a limited amount of space in your trough, and it didn't matter what you put in, everything contributed to eating up that allowance of space. So you wanted to make sure that when you fed them TMR, you fed them nothing but TMR to completely maximize. So on a full trough of 10,000 litres, again, it's a small example, but it's just an example. If you're putting in 6,000 litres into that of TMR, then they're only at 100% productivity for 60% of of your food supply. After that, they start to drop down in productivity as they start to go to the silage and then the hay. So to maximize your money, you want them at 100% of the time for the entire 100% of the food trough. So you want to feed them nothing but TMR. I think this is a little bit different. Based on the fact that we're still throwing in hay and silage as part of our power food mix, I honestly think that food is a little bit different this time around. So let's whip up one more batch. So I want one bale of straw, sorry, of hay. Let's try and grab that. Sorry for the little gap in gameplay there for a second while I was talking. I needed to grab a drink. Making myself thirsty. This is what happens when you eat a bag of very salty crisps just before you come on, just before you start recording, you get very thirsty. Bad planning on my part there. So let's put our hay in. We'll come back for the straw in a second. What we want now is 2 scoops of silage. Let's try and go from one of the sides this time rather than down the middle. There we go, it's the first one. A shame there isn't more space around the silage bunker in some respects. It would be great to be able to store the bales right next to this to our silage so that it would make mixing quicker and easier. However, it's a bit tight on the farm. Space is at a premium. Let's just pick up that silage that we dropped. There we go. So we're gonna get our second scoop. That gate bugs me every time now. The one that just refuses to open now. I really don't know why it started doing that. It was fine to start with, and then all of a sudden it just stopped, and I don't know why. And by the time I'd already realized it had stopped working, I'd already recorded some and posted hours of footage, so I couldn't really just say, oh well, we'll restart a new farm, because yeah, I'd already published footage, so that wasn't going to happen. Oh, I'm spilling silage again. This is the problem. For the convenience, I'd like having stop and go braking switched on, sorry, turned off, so that I don't have to. Or, is it on or off? Which way round is it? Stop and go braking. So it's switched on at the moment, which means basically if I keep holding down forward when I'm reversing, then I'll come to a stop and then immediately start going forward again. For convenience, I find it better. But it does mean that, as you've seen, when I try and go up to the bucket to or to the feeding the mixer to drop some material in, and I want to slow down my approach, you will see me sometimes just start to tip and start backing up, and then I have to keep jostling forward and backward to reposition the bucket again. So I just have to be wary of that. Okay, so that should be enough. Jump out, jump in, ratio's good. Let's go dump another load of food. See if we can actually see it going up a little. Cow just poking its head through the railings next to us there. Yeah, I'm not seeing any. And now we're at maximum food capacity. Okay, so we'll park the mixer just there. Oh no, because we need to clean in here, don't we? All right, so let's pick that up. So we're gonna have to park this up. We'll park this by the bales. It's getting a little untidy around here, unfortunately. With big clumps of straw everywhere, and there we go. So we'll park that there like that. So the 800 is done now. We don't need the 800 anymore. It's certainly way too powerful and expensive to run to use as a glorified water transport. So I'm just going to park her up here for a moment. Let's jump back into the swamp, the 700. So that straw is just going to get left there for now. Obviously, we'll pick that up and move around with it with the next food mixing session that we do, and use the rest of that up. But let's drop off our claw just here. I'm gonna stick that. You see, we have a bucket, and we have bale spikes, so we could have used those, but that's an all-in-one purpose tool, multi-purpose tool. So that saves us having to keep switching implements and in the middle of our mixing, we don't have to keep switching to a bucket when we do our feed. We don't have to then keep switching back to a bale spike to grab a bale. That's why I quite like that little clawed bucket. So we have some water still in here. I'm trying to remember where we actually filled our water up. I think there was a water point up by the fuel, wasn't there? Let's go put some water in here for the cows in the bath. You can just see the water level going up a bit. That's going to be nowhere near enough water, is it? Actually, that's not far off. That's not far off at all. So we will, come back in and top it up to full, because anything that's left over we can use with our sheep when we top the sheep up. Trying to be very careful not to bump our equipment out the way. Here's our water pump up here, so oh, I'm refueling, aren't I? Just finish refueling and hopefully it'll then give me the option to fill the trailer. No, it still asks me to refuel, so I'm gonna have to have to turn around and go in the other way, aren't I? Okay, so things that we are learning about our farm. Some slightly unrealistic reversing there, just to shove the trailer out of the way. Got to approach like this to fill the water trailer. And even then, looks like we've got to get. Oh Christ! Looks like we're gonna have to get really tight to it as well. It's quite lightweight, this trailer, so it's really easy to just push around in ways that you're not supposed to be able to push it. You know, you would do some serious shearing damage to your connection if you just pushed it around like that, especially if it was loaded up. Come on, why won't this? There we go. Refill water trailer. So I had the wrong item selected. I was trying to refill the weight. Obviously, you can't do that. That's why the prompt wasn't popping up. Alright, so. So now we need to go and get ourselves some grass. And that's easy enough to do. I mean, there's plenty of grass in there. We're just literally going to go in with a single front mower, a collection wagon, just scoop a little bit of grass up and drop it straight in the food trough, and we really are highly unlikely to need much of it at all. Oh, come on. Just having one of those episodes today, I think. Everything that could go wrong is going wrong. We're having problems with the food issue, you know, I'm completely unprepared and needing to just stop in the middle of commentary just to get a drink out of the fridge. Now I'm knocking all my equipment all over the place, driving into stuff. It's not going well. This episode is not going well. And this is the wrong trough. This is the grass trough. I'm trying to put water in the grass trough. Brain is gone. Half an hour of recording and already my brain has turned to mush. Alright, so there we go. Let's fill the rest of this water tank up. There we go. So we use less than 1,000 litres to fill up that tank. That's kind of what I expected. So, and the gate is opening. It must be the proximity of this water trailer that was doing it. It must have been because it was too close. So, where can we dump the trailer? There. Let's put the trailer in that spot there. So the mystery of the gate is, as indeed I kind of suspected it might be, was the fact that, you know, there was something too close to it that was stopping it from activating. There we go. Look at, oh, that's so much better. Oh, that's a joy. It works again. Yay. So if you've been watching at home and going, you've got something in the wrong place, you know, you're too close to the gate, that's why it's not working. Next time, you know, if you were that guy or gal, next time please put it in the comments. I do read the comments. If someone had put that in, I would have moved that. I would have figured that out a little bit quicker. So what do we need? Yes, we're after a mower, aren't we? We want the front mower, and we want the collection wagon, which means I need to drop the weight. Let's put the weight down just here. We'll just use the grass that's in the meadow for the cows. That is what it's there for. Same as we do with the sheep. You know, we use the sheep meadow or the sheep pasture for feeding them. We'll do exactly the same up here. So let's switch to the mower. Let's unfold, lower, turn on. Switch to the collection wagon, lower, turn on, and off we go. Alright, so we're starting to get things back under control. Normal service is starting to be resumed. Yeah. A semblance of normality. Or not, depending on your opinion of how my episodes tend to go. Maybe earlier was normal service and now this is breaking from norm. I suppose it depends what opinion you have of me when I'm playing. I like to think that I do things pretty well most of the time. So that should hopefully be enough. Let's go see. Is that enough grass? If it's not, we can always do another quick lap. But we shouldn't need much grass, I wouldn't have thought. Why won't it let me unload? That is odd. It's given me the option to force unload, but I don't want to force unload. Maybe I need to. Yeah, why isn't it giving me that option? Ah, there we go. Yeah, I was just not quite in the right position. So, there we go. We tipped our grass in. How are we looking? Not quite full. We just need another couple thousand. So, we're on. Collection again. That little patch there. I don't like to leave trails of grass where I can, where possible. I like to be a bit more precise and clean in what I leave behind. It's not always possible to be 100% perfect, but we like to strive for it. Okay, so that should be enough now. So we get the last of that grass there. So turn that off. Cow's already chomping on that grass. See if I can just park this thing between the two of them. Hey, not bad. Almost, almost. There we go. That's pretty good. And that is pretty much spot on. We got pretty much as close to being full on grass as we could without actually having any left over. I'm happy with that. Yeah, we've effectively got 6 days worth of grass in there, so. After a couple of moments of madness and mediocrity, we have a moment of brilliance there. Albeit maybe fortuitous, but it's what I meant to do it like that, and that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. In fact, what I'm also going to do is I'm actually going to start moving this one in, storing this. See, there we go, mediocrity's back. We've got ourselves completely wedged. Didn't take long, did it? You know, in the first Austin Powers movie where he's just backing up and in the corridor on the cart and he's completely sideways in the really narrow corridor. That's what this feels like, trying to squeeze myself around a little bit. There we go. Finally. What I want to do is I want to put this in here so that I can actually shortcut through the building if I'm using that this tractor now. There we go. Drop off the right piece of equipment. So we had that one moment of shining brilliance and just made a complete fool of myself afterwards. All right, so mower dropped off. So we're done with the cows. How are our sheep looking? They're good enough for another couple of days. We don't have to worry about them too much. But there we go. We have cows. We have 18 of them. They are at 100% productivity. It's going to be a long time till the next one breeds. So, yeah, we are definitely going to have to look at buying in more cows as well. But we have now started producing some milk. That'll be great when the clock hits midnight and we get a nice little payment of cash for sold milk. We have manure starting very, very slowly, but starting to be produced. Same with slurry. Fact, oops, wrong button. Let's turn off the tractor. There we go. Let's just have a wander over and see. Yes, so there we go. This is definitely where our manure spawns. I was confident it was. But let's check our slurry. Just try to see if we can actually get a visual representation. I'd love to see if this level rises. It must do as the slurry gets, as we gain more and more slurry. We're still at 0% effectively, so it's going to be. That's a pretty big looking, capacity tank by the look of it. So, we've got about 5 minutes of footage left, give or take. Don't really want to break onto another big job just yet. Rather start that on the next episode. So, I know I have still got some equipment to put away, so let's go grab that up on the top field. Well, I say the top field, it's actually the west field. The field here at the top of the hill is what I meant. I know what I meant to say, even if you had no idea. So, other side. And grab our windrowers. There we go. Off we go back down to the farm, store these away. So we now have all three animal types up and running. We have our sheep, and they are producing wool for us. We have almost two complete pallets, I think. We have pigs. They are happily munching their way through their food and starting to produce slurry and manure for us. And we now have cows. They are here. They are fed. They are strawed. They are watered. Makes them sound like plants. They are, fully looked after. They are in the equivalent of cow spa, day spa. They've got total mixed ration. They've got the straw bedding. They've got food and water. They've got everything they need. So, I think what we'll do, just to finish this episode off, is we'll shovel some of that silage and we'll start producing a little bit of digestate as well. Yes, we do have the slurry tanker, don't we? I know you can't mix and match slurry on this with digestate. So, let's have a look at the store. Do we have a larger bucket option? That has a 25,000, no, 25,000, 2,500 litre capacity, although slightly under. Ooh, that is a bit bigger, 28.6. That bucket is bigger than the one we have, but it is not bigger than this. And this is the bucket that we do have, which is pitiful. We'll make do with what we've got now. There's not much point buying the silage fork for just a tiny little bit of capacity. And what I'll probably do as well is check the mod list and see if there's a larger bucket that I can use just as, you know, for a front loader attachment for tractors that gives us that extra capacity. But we'll spend the next minute or two, we'll shovel a bit of silage and bring in a bit of cash. I honestly think the pricing, if we look at it here, the pricing for silage is way too high. Look at it, it's over 1,000 for 1,000 litres, and that's a low price. We've seen it higher than that as when we've looked in the past. So I honestly think that the silage price is probably set a little bit too high, especially when you consider the size of this map. You know, the fields aren't that expensive. It's not a particularly big map. You get all those golden nuggets given to you pretty much straight away. See that little scoop there? That should not have been 2,500. It's too much. We're getting paid way too much. This is more in line with Farming Sim 15 prices, I think. Means we're going to get a nice bit of cash for what we've got here, but it does, you know, it does kind of, you know, spoil the economy a little bit when everything is so so easy to earn. But you know, there's a way around that. We just don't do that much in terms of silage, you know, and that way we don't end up, you know, completely rolling in money that was, you know, very, very easy to earn and completely outstripped, you know, all of our other financial, you know, operations that we have in place. So where are we with our fields? What's our growth state? I can't remember where we left the fields. Are they planted? Are they still? No, so we haven't even planted. Okay, so next episode then, when we come back in the next episode, we will clean up those fields. Well, don't even need to clean them, do we? We have a cultivating cedar, so we will start replanting those fields next episode. And start doing, you know, the fertilizing process as well, and getting ready to weed those fields as the crop grows in. So I'm going to take this point to thank you all for watching. Don't forget to drop a like if you've enjoyed the video, and if you're enjoying the series, then do please keep watching. If you have any comments that you want to drop, or you want any feedback about what you've seen in the series, or just anything in general, or maybe something that you'd like to see on the channel going forward, then please do drop that in the comments box. You know, let me know in the down below, as I say every episode. You can also go on my Facebook page. I have got a thread there on my page all about, you know, wanting to get feedback from you guys, so you can reply in the comments section of that post, and let me know, you know, how you can, you know, how you can help shape the channel going forward, you know, with footage that you'd like to see, both in terms of Farming Sim and in terms of other games as well. You know, obviously we have got No Man's Sky is now live on the channel. I've got Sandy Bay on the way. This episode will probably go up after Sandy Bay has been released, but it'll be close. Sandy Bay will probably be out the day or so before this episode. So yeah, Sandy Bay is coming, and so keep yourself, you know, ready for that one. Massey Manor is obviously out there as well. We've got a couple episodes live. Another one will be going live later today. So do keep watching those vids. And if you don't like the footage, or you're not finding it interesting, you want to see a different farm, let me know in the comments. Again, I can't make footage that you want to see without knowing what you guys want to see. So until then, I can only kind of make the footage that I want to make and hope that you guys like it. If there is something that you want to see change, then obviously if you let me know, I can act on that, and we can start to make improvements to the stuff that is going up on the channel. So yeah, there's the Facebook page, Jim Bob Plays Games. It's facebook.com/pages/JimBobPlaysGames. Then obviously there's the comment section here as well. You know, like and subscribe for more videos, and as always, I will catch you on the farm very soon.